party hop.
Hey, fellow Trek Chatters, and Merry Christmas. Welcome to the Christmas episode of Pittsburgh's Trek Chat. I'm Pit Trekkie. Well, it's Christmas Day at last. I'm actually filming this on Christmas Day 2017. I wanted to film a little episode, just kind of spread a little holiday cheer. I'm also dedicating this episode to my twin brother, Matt. He serves in our military, and he is out of state right now, wasn't able to make it home this year. So I'm hoping that with the topic of this episode, that he'll get a little touch of home and a little touch of nostalgia. So Matt, Merry Christmas from Brandy and me. So what I wanted to discuss in today's episode are some of the gifts that I've gotten over the years as a Star Trek fan. I have my 10 specific favorite gifts that I've gotten over the years, and I'd like to share it with all of you. I'm not going to do this in any, like, I like this item better than the other kind of order. I'm just going to do it in year order. All right. The very first gift that I am going to show you here is my captain's log book. I got this Christmas of 1991 when I was 11 years old. This was for the 25th anniversary of the original Star Trek series. It's still in really good shape. This book is very important to me because what I do is nearly every Christmas, I write a little entry in here about how that Christmas went. And I actually have my very first entry here in the book. Captain's Log, Stardate 404.6. This is my first mission aboard the new USS Enterprise. Our position, my aunt's house. We are investigating my cousins, Dean and Anne. They have been acting weird. We are attempting to get them. So that was my very first journal entry when I was 11 years old, spying on my cousins. That was what my brothers and I did. So this book is very important to me. The second item I'd like to go over with you that I got in Christmas was the good old Next Generation Transporter. I got this Christmas 1993 when I was 13. I was actually a little afraid that it wasn't going to work, but it does work. I just put batteries in it. Get that on there. Let's see here if it's lit. It is on. All right. And always had a lot of fun with this thing. It was the lights and mirrors, it played different little tricks and showed you the things can transport away. So I've loved this toy for a long time. I remember when we actually got it, my brothers and I were trying to transport away parts of our cats. We'd put our cat's paw in there. One time we even stuck his head in there and made it disappear. So we've had a lot of fun with this beauty, and I'm glad that it still works. Also that same year at Christmas, I got something else that I really loved, which were these original series action figures from Playmates. Now, I don't like keeping my action figures in their original boxes. I hate that because I'm one of those people that with an action figure, I like to feel it, I like to hold it, I like to touch it to make it feel more real to me rather than just looking at it through a box. Maybe someday I'll get another set of action figures in the original box. But I love these things. I think they're very well detailed, articulated, the little pieces that come with them, the communicators, the phasers are very detailed. I just think that they're amazing, and I don't think, even though, you know, a lot of the Art Asylum Diamond Select toys are so much more elaborate and a lot bigger, I don't think you can go wrong with these. I think these were the best figures that they ever made, all the Playmates figures. So those are always going to be very special to me. Moving on to 1996, when I was 16, for the 30th anniversary of Star Trek, I got the official Ken and Barbie doll. Now, I was just talking about how I don't like keeping things in the boxes, but a few things I've kept in boxes, this is still in pretty much very mint condition for the most part, but it's still in really good shape. I think they did a really nice job on these dolls. I think the uniforms were spectacular, the little communicator tricorder that they gave them, just the detail on these things was extraordinary. I just didn't have the heart to open them. A couple years later, I was working on doing therapy with a family, and a family actually had a set of these that they had loose, and they gave them to me. So I ended up getting my own little loose set anyway. But these beauties have been in my curio cabinet in my Star Trek man cave for years now, and they'll continue to be so. Next step, moving on to Christmas of 1998. Star Trek The Next Generation Monopoly. This is a lot of fun to play. It's got special different little pewter tokens here. It's got Picard, Riker, Data, Geordi, Worf, Crusher, Troy, and Wesley. Instead of like hotels and houses, you use like starships and star bases. Instead of paying with cash, you pay with gold pressed latinum. And what you're doing is you're actually paying for peace treaties with different races rather than different properties. So this is a lot of fun. I even played this when I first started in mental health. I used to take it to one of the kids' houses I did therapy with. Loved it. Got his mind off of stuff that was making him angry or frustrated. So if any of you guys ever get an opportunity to play a Star Trek Monopoly game, please do it because it's a lot of fun. All right. We're going to move on next to Christmas of 2001. I was 21 years old. I had just gotten engaged to my beautiful wife, Brandy, and she bought me this for my very first Christmas gift. Nice drawing of Spock. This has been in my bedroom and my man caves ever since. It hasn't left my side and it's never going to leave my side. It's very special to me. I remember my father-in-law was beyond excited for me to open this gift. When I got it, it's one of my pride and joys, and it came from Brandy's heart. So I'm always going to treasure this picture. It's never going to go anywhere. All right. The next gift I would like to go over is from 2009. 2009, obviously the rebooted first Kelvin movie came out, and Eggo Waffles had some sort of promotion going on for not only a flash drive, which I did get that year, which my wife is using now, but I also got this. It was a little collector's plate. It's plastic, and it's kind of 3D, kind of shows the Enterprise in warp speed, in the warp effect. I really love this thing. I just love the blue in it. I love the way it moves. So I have it displayed in my man cave on one of my shelves. Beautiful. If you can ever find any of these online, get them. It's a nice little trinket, not very expensive. All right, moving on next to Christmas 2012, when I was 32, I got this awesome coat from my sister-in-law, Heather. She was so excited for me to open this gift. I love this coat. She got it just a regular hoodie jacket with the Star Trek insignia on there. I can't tell you how many times I've worn this thing. I love this thing to this day. I still wear it. It's got a little snug on me, so I gotta lose some of all this weight here. But it's definitely got a special place for me, coming from my sister-in-law, because it came from her heart. It really did. So I'm always gonna continue to wear that. All right, another gift that I got, this is from my other sister-in-law, Shannon. I love these things. I have them displayed in my man cave. This is another item I have not been able to get out of my box because I don't want them ruined. But it's a set of Star Trek collector's cups. As you can see, it has different sayings and different pictures. There's one with Scotty here says, "I'm giving it all she's got, Captain." Captain Kirk here, my personal hero, as, what is it? "Would you find me a formidable enemy?" Spock says, "Seems logical to me, Captain." And then the other one is Dr. McCoy says, "I'm a doctor, not an engineer." Sounds like something Dr. McCoy would say. So yeah, so I haven't been able to get these out of the boxes, and I don't plan to. I want to keep them in good shape and keep them the way they've been. All right, and then the last item that I wanted to go over is one of my all-time favorite Star Trek gifts. Is I just got it this year for my 37th Christmas. The Autobiography of Captain Jean-Luc Picard. I got this from my twin brother, Matt. I cannot wait to start reading this. I'm hoping that with my busy schedule with working two jobs that I'll be able to find the time. But Captain Picard is my absolute all-time favorite Star Trek captain. Captain Kirk's been a hero to me, but Captain Picard's always been my favorite. So I'm really looking forward to reading this book and seeing what they came up with for his whole entire backstory from time he was born all the way up until it says he retired. Alright, so if I happen to finish up this book, I might be able to give it a review later on in a future episode of the show. So that's basically it for all the Christmas gifts that I wanted to share with you. Those were some of my top favorite Star Trek gifts I ever got. Believe me, I got plenty more of Star Trek gifts. I just happened to pick the ones that had the most memories for me and the most heart. So we're not going to do open channel this week, but I am going to ask you, if you want, why don't you, in the comments section, please write down what some of your Star Trek favorite Christmas gifts were in the past. I'd love to hear some of what your stories are. I think it would be a lot of fun, and I really care what you guys, to share the stories. We're Trekkies, we're family as Trekkies. So that'll end the Christmas episode. Please, like I said, on YouTube, please go to my page, my YouTube channel. Go type in Pittsburgh's Trek Chat or type in Pit Trekkie. It'll take you to all of my videos. Please feel free to comment below in the comment section. Also, you can go onto my Facebook page. You can type in Pittsburgh's Trek Chat, or you can go to facebook.com/PGH Trek Chat. You can also go to my Twitter account at PGH Trek Chat. Until next time, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all of you. Matt, we'll hopefully see you again soon. And may yins live long and prosper. Happy holiday.